Ring around your mom. I'm so fucking over you. Oh yeah, oh yeah, no originality. Hi everyone, welcome back to Ring Around the Rosie, the only show where we all get the plague and die. So here lately it seems like we've been seeing a bit of a resurgence in the genre of pop punk. Kind of an oxymoron from the beginning, but I guess it's more of the style of music than necessarily the lifestyle of the artist. So that's what we're going to define pop punk as. You know, it's the three chord power chord guitar songs. A lot of times they're catered towards teenagers and they're kind of angsty. Think stuff like Blink 182 and later Green Day. Heralding this resurgence are highly acclaimed artists such as MGK, a literal messiah. He's the second coming of Jesus. And Olivia Rodrigo, who I have mixed opinions on because she stole riffs from people. Or if she didn't, you know, steal riffs from people herself, the people who wrote her songs stole those riffs for her, and I'm actually not sure which is worse. But yeah, Olivia Rodrigo's newest, or only, album is actually pretty good. All the singles are really solid, and I thought when she was first coming out, I thought that her music was really, really cool, and that it was awesome that it was having the sort of mainstream appeal that it was, and I was like, this'll be like a new wave of cool, or at least, you know, mildly interesting music coming out. But I was wrong. I apologize. It seems that the byproduct of this pop punk resurgence is a lot of labels are trying to get in on it with some of the most generic songs ever written or recorded by anybody ever, and a lot of times they are, you know, manufactured to work a certain way, and it seems work they do. For example, we've got the song A B C D E F U. By Gail, which I didn't really mind it when it first came out, but then after it's been run into the ground and played every hour on multiple radio stations, it kind of starts to grate. But now we can say, move aside Gail, move aside Olivia Rodrigo, move aside Machine Gun Kelly. Leah Kate is here, and she's taking you people to school on how to write a pop punk anthem. Or more specifically, a fuck you anthem. So the main thing that seems to characterize a lot of these songs is that they've got this like fake, edgy persona to them. A lot of them are breakup songs. A lot of times when I hear a curse word in a song, it just makes me laugh, because it's like they're trying really hard to tell you that they're punk, you know, these are fighting words, they're telling you. And a lot of them use these really weird, like, almost nursery rhyme type of lyrics that, I don't know, they feel very patronizing, especially since I know that most of these songs were written by, you know, these executives sitting in their ivory towers thinking to themselves, what will the youth of the nation find appealing? Let's rewrite a bunch of nursery rhymes as breakup songs with the F word. That ought to do it. But with a lot of other artists trying to get on this trend, they seem to look at it as a trend where they do like one or two songs that kind of fit into that mold, and then they do other stuff, maybe like some ballads or some more emotionally impactful anything. But Leah Kate seems to have made it her mission in life to just make the same song over and over and over again with varying levels of success and quality. Because we have to suffer through this, I want whoever watches this who doesn't know about this to suffer through it as well. So join me as we dive deep into Leah Kate's discography of singles. All right, so here we see Leah Kate's channel. She has almost 50,000 subscribers, which is not really that many when we've got, you know. Leah Kate, 10 Things I Hate About You official visualizer has 4.2 million views, which are not shabby numbers at all. So there's obviously like a, you know what? Let me take a quick moment right here to just say, let me take a moment here just to say, I personally find this to be super derivative, especially when these people are all kind of ripping off each other and doing like the same thing over and over and over again. A lot of the lyrics seem kind of toxic. Take a look at like any Tramp Stamp song, for example. I don't really like using the word industry plant, but a lot of these artists are exactly that. Like Gayle made up a whole story about an ex to go with her song ABCD, etc. And they later said that this story was entirely fabricated. Every show she played, she'd introduce the song with this like deeply personal and moving story about her experience with this dude and how it inspired her to write the song. And then later you find out she didn't write the song and it was all a marketing scheme. But all of that being said, I am still, you know, as a person trying to be an artist myself, you gotta look at stuff like this and think, hey, at least they made it. You know, maybe they didn't make it huge yet, but they have like their foot in the door. They can pivot from this to do whatever they want, really. They have multiple songs with millions and millions of views. Gayle's music video for ABCD, etc. has over 100 million views. They're doing very well for themselves. So, you know, congratulations. I just personally don't love it, so I'm just going to sit here and make fun of it for a second. I hope you don't mind. And it looks like she's been releasing music for about 3 years, so that's pretty cool. She's been grinding for a while. In her description, it says, Leah Kate writes pop rock anthems that cut to the bone, pairing booming radio-ready choruses with dizzying hyper-specific detail. Her songs are intimate, relatable, and razor-sharp. With the success of the biting breakup song 10 Things I Hate About You, the LA native is realizing her dreams of pop stardom by reaching deep into her innermost feelings and sharing them with us. A snippet of the track went nuclear on TikTok, and Kate was inundated with requests for the full song. Days later, 10 Things I Hate About You was out, and it zoomed past 20 million streams in its first month. Yeah, again, let me reiterate this. There is obviously a large, you know, audience for this type of stuff, even though the vast majority of what I've seen on the internet related to Leah Kate's music, Gayle's music, you know, all the songs that kind of fall into this category are their negative opinions. 20 million listens in its first month. You know, there's no way all of that is bots, I think. Since taking her first singing lesson at 5, Kate knew that music was her destiny. Even when it was hard to muster the motivation for school and work, she always hustled as a songwriter. She penned the empowering Fuck Up the Friendship, which eventually found an audience on TikTok. Feeling momentum building, Kate got to work and found her sound with FU Anthem. She has a Discord, she's got $60 shirts. Cool, 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 cool. All right. Let's take a look at some of her music, shall we? We've got 10 Things I Hate About You. Let's just say this one's probably the best out of all of them. This isn't quite as terrible as some of the other ones are. And fittingly, it also has the most views. It's still not great, and it still uses that, like, this dumb nursery rhyme or, like, counting down type of thing. But I guess that's super popular on TikTok, so let's check it out. You're selfish, nine, you're jaded, eight, the dumbest guy I've dated until you're naked. Only 6 seconds and I had to fake it. Five, you're tough, but three, you still got mommy issue. Your friends must suck if they think you're cool. Keep buying bottles with your dad. Your friends must suck if they think that you're cool. You're a drunk who's obsessed with his drool. Move over, Kendrick Lamar. There's just nothing that can top this in terms of like lyrical prowess. You gross me out. Now I've got the ache and I've got a list of why you don't get. Once again, corporations looking for something from like what they consider to be youth culture to appropriate. I've got the ick. Ah. I'm also mad because 10 Things I Hate About You is an amazing movie, and its reputation should not be tarnished by having anything associated with this song. Another thing that's interesting is that even on some of, like, this song has all the top comments are positive comments, then some of these other ones are a lot worse, and they also have mostly positive comments. But everywhere else on the internet, all I've seen is negativity towards these songs. Is it possible that they're removing comments? I don't know. Is it possible that I left a comment that got removed? Who knows? All right, so now we're on to the real offender. The other songs, whatever. Like I said, super, super derivative and all a bunch of other negative words. But this one's just kind of creepy and weird, especially with like the music video, and just everything about this gives me the ick. So yeah, let me show you this. Pay attention to some of these lyrics. Here we go.
Twinkle, twinkle, little bitch, just another narcissist. Hate your guts, you make me sick. I'm so fucking over it. Twinkle, twinkle, little bitch, I wish.
What is this? The fuck is this? Why am I. What? Why? Why would you subject us to this? What is. Look at this. Freaking little baby person with a man head. Look at that.
Girl, same bar, see you every weekend. Cheap tricks, bullshit, get them back in your bed. 26 still in your mom's basement and telling everyone you're about to make it.
So in this song, she says someone else is making emo songs and that they're cheesy. Then she sings this song, and then she, you know, the music video tries to be self-aware with we making nursery songs into breakup songs now. Don't drop it, please. I'm begging you. Wait, my heart is bad. Let me see the my heart is bad one. I wish I never heard this. It's also funny that, like, creators talk about hate comments a lot on YouTube. Or, like, troll comments. Stuff like this. I wish I'd never heard this. We making nursery rhyme songs. This is not what a hate comment. Obviously, these are troll comments. But, like, so I've been on YouTube for a couple of years now. And I remember sometimes I had comments where I, like, screenshotted them. They made, like, my parents super, super concerned about me continuing to make YouTube content. Multiple paragraphs of, like, psychoanalyzing me as a person, comments with vile, filthy language, comments with all this like overtly sexual stuff. So many creators like talk about hate comments and then they'll just show stuff like, you suck. Yeah, I don't know. Anyway, again, I have nothing against this artist. I think it's awesome that they're making it. At the end of this video, I think to try and balance this video, I'm gonna point you in the direction of a band that you might like. Did she really think people were gonna like this?
Emo boy, sad songs that they're all about me. Think you're gonna be a star, not likely. Boy, you should be crying. I'm a fucking die.
Okay, well, that's Twinkle Twinkle Little Bitch. Thumbs up, amazing song. This song definitely has words, and I definitely hear things. This person is one of the artists of all time, and I couldn't have said it better myself. So at the end of this, I'm just gonna say, Leah Kate, please stop. Please stop going in this direction. All right, so that's that. Thanks for cringing with me. That was very fun. I hope you're having a good day. And before I go, let me just say, Leah Kate, please stop. Please stop going in this direction. Because this is seriously kind of weird, the way that she's like going about doing this. Like this video being, the song being kind of sexual and a lot of the lyrics having these double entendre themes and everything being like a nursery rhyme and the baby man and the, you know, the her crawling around. It's weird, freaking weird. If you want something to cleanse your ears out after blessing them with that, all the beauty that was contained within Twinkle Twinkle Little Bitch, you should check out the band Wet Leg. The catch is their music is actually good. Link to one of their songs in the description. Or even their new album, yeah. Link to their new album in the description. Go listen to that. It's good. Well, that's about all the time we have for today, kids. Always remember, God made you special.
But tell me there's a God after watching that sad display.
Be sure to tune in next week for One Man, One Watermelon, the show where I attempt to fit an entire watermelon in my mouth.